Articulate Storyline 360 and Articulate Rise are two of the most popular e-learning authoring tools on the market. Unfortunately, they are both part of the Articulate 360 suite. Now the question is, which tool should you use? So in this video, I will help you make an informed decision based on the needs of the project. Even though Storyline and Rise are both e-learning authoring tools, they have very different strengths and weaknesses, and they are each better suited for specific types of e-learning projects. So if you have the Articulate 360 suite, then you have access to both of these tools. Now let's take a look at when you should use which one. So we'll start off with Articulate Storyline. So as you may or may not know, Articulate Storyline is a slide-based authoring tool. So if you've used PowerPoint, you know we're kind of working with a blank slate slide here. So as you can see, this is us inside of Storyline. This square right here, that is our slide. That's what we're working with. We can change the size of that slide. So if we want a different aspect ratio, for example, we can put it into this different aspect ratio. But every single slide in your e-learning experience will be this exact aspect ratio. It is not mobile responsive. You know, you can, if you turn your phone landscape, it will basically go in landscape mode, but things aren't going to be resizing on the screen and layouts aren't going to be shifting based on the screen width. So it's not truly mobile responsive. You know, it can turn and go into landscape mode on a phone, but that is a very low bar. That's a very low bar if you're going to look for something that's mobile responsive. So it's a slide-based tool. So that is one con of Storyline. Not mobile responsive, but we're getting into the pros now. You can use Storyline to create highly custom interactions. And that's because its feature set is quite rich when it comes to an authoring tool. So it has a timeline. You know, you can time things to come in at certain points on the slide. You can use triggers to add interactivity to any kind of object or element that you'd like. There are variables and conditions so that you can store dynamic data about the user experience. And then you can even embed full web objects, and you can execute JavaScript to do some really, really custom and complex things. Okay, so this is really good for e-learning simulations, games, and very complex interactions that you're not going to get out of the box from a tool like Rise. Okay, so e-learning simulations, by that I mean these story-driven, scenario-based learning experiences where you can go into them, you're making choices, and your choices are impacting certain variables about your experience. If you didn't see the video last week, it was these top five, like the best e-learning examples that I found. Those are all scenario-based learning experiences. And even though all of them were not created with Storyline, you could create every single one of those with Articulate Storyline. So that's what I mean by these, you know, these simulation type experiences. You know, we can make choices, it can affect our happiness, it can affect how much money we have in the bank. That's what we can use variables for. And then we can shift the user experience or branch to different consequences based on the user's choices. Okay, so if you haven't seen that video, I'll link it in the description and in the top right of this video. Check it out. It's the best e-learning examples, and maybe that will give you some inspiration about what you can really accomplish in Storyline. So now let's dive into Rise. Okay, Rise is a very different tool, and we will take a look at that together as well in case you have not seen it yet. But this is templated and mobile responsive. Okay, so you're basically picking and choosing your interactions and media. So whereas with Storyline, we have this blank slate and we're just adding things to the page. Like, it's literally a blank slate. We create everything from scratch. We're putting on our text, our images, our videos, whatever we want. We're doing it all from scratch. And there are templates you can download and fill some things in. But by default, this is a from scratch kind of tool. Now, if we go to Articulate Rise, this is the Rise editor. You see it's web-based, it's in a browser, and this looks like we're in a course, but we can actually change all of this. So this is like the back end of it. This is how we build the course for Devlin. You see we can just change the text here, delete things, change the formatting. It's all very embedded in the tool. So here we go. It's this menu. So we can edit the content here. And I just started with one of Rise's templates. You can build this from scratch, but I just want to show you the variety of some of these things that you can add. So here's a quote on image block, for example. Then you have a text block and a numbered list. You can have this tab interaction. So we're not building these things from scratch. We actually can just press a plus icon to add something between these blocks. And you can see on the left, we have all of these different choices about what we want to add here. So we can add some plain text. And even within that, we have different options. So this is what I mean by templated, right? So these templates are already determined for us. It's a very visual editor. We just look at what one looks most similar to what we want. We pick it, and there we go. And you can see we can do the same with images, a full width image, an image with text. And they handle all of the padding, all of the sizing, all of that. And the thing about Rise is it will resize and reformat based on what device you're using. So notice here, you know, you can go through this on your own time, but they have all sorts. You can add audio, you can add video, you can embed things just like you can in Storyline, and even like a PDF attachment, for example, that people can open and download. And then of course there are the interactive elements. You know, these are kind of cool. They added a scenario one for some very, you know, non-complex scenario-based questions. You know, so there is a good variety, flashcards, different buttons, and then there are knowledge checks too, so that if you did have some sort of quiz, you could report that quiz score to a learning management system, and you can export this as a scoring package just like you can with Storyline. Okay, so as you can imagine with a tool like this, where it's basically just picking what you want and then swapping out the text and the images and the videos and just making the media match, it's very easy and fast to create these learning experiences that will look good no matter what device you're on. So you don't need very strong visual design skills here because you're basically just swapping out colors, fonts, and you need some eye for design to pick the interaction or the media type that will look best at that spot. But again, this is very easy. With Storyline, to make something that looks good, you need to have some strong ideas. You need to be somewhat trained in creating good layouts and have some visual design basics down, whereas with Rise, they kind of handle that for you. So I'd say that something like this is great for information-heavy e-learning. So something where, you know, you have a PDF or you have a PowerPoint and you just need to dump all of that information into, you know, an e-learning package, essentially, Rise is perfect for this. You can embed videos where they're needed. You can add those multiple choice knowledge checks. There's no need to use a tool like Articulate Storyline, which can handle some really heavy lifting to create one of these information-heavy e-learning experiences that you can create more quickly and easily in Rise. And it also could be a better experience because it looks better and it's mobile responsive, which is a huge plus. Like if you want some people looking at this stuff on their phones or iPads, Articulate Rise is a really good tool to use if you need that true mobile responsiveness. And as for competitors, you know, Articulate Storyline's main competitor, I'd say, is Adobe Captivate. And then Articulate Rise, there's a really good tool that's like this called Chameleon Creator, which again, it's the same type of idea. You pick the interactions you want, but Chameleon Creator, they're not as popular, but they have some really slick interaction types, nice animations, and really, really small file sizes. So definitely check that out if you maybe don't have access to the Articulate 360 suite or you're just looking for some new tools out there. So to wrap things up, when it comes to Storyline versus Rise, use Storyline for simulations, complex interactions, and really these story-driven, scenario-based learning experiences that you really want to immerse people in. And you can use Rise for these information-heavy learning products. So I know a lot of the work out there right now is for these information-heavy learning products. So if you want to get some ideas about how to shift to something that's a bit more performance-oriented, you know, one of these e-learning simulations, check out the video from last week. Again, I will link that. That people have been saying that has been giving them a lot of inspiration to do things that are a bit more creative and story-driven. And then also check out the growing action mapping playlist. So if you're not familiar with action mapping, it's created by Kathy Moore. It's this streamlined approach to business training, essentially, training for corporations. And that approach lends itself really well to these story-driven, scenario-based e-learning experiences. So I will link both of these things in the comments below, and I will see you in the next video.